It is very evident that the leader of North Korea is fascinated with power and attention. In this photograph, you will see long-range ballistic missiles that can be fired from mobile launchers with the capability of reaching the U.S., armed with nuclear weapons. This is a very serious situation, the most serious situation that we've ever been in our lifetime, and not something to take lightly. In a photograph the other day, in the background, you could see the leader of North Korea with some of his associates and a picture that would show targets that they intend to strike here in the U.S. And this includes Washington, D.C., Los Angeles, Austin, Texas, and Hawaii. The United States is deploying 14 new ground-based missile interceptors in Alaska to help protect the United States. Most concerned would be the West Coast of the United States and the East Coast of the United States. If the U.S. is forced to strike North Korea, we would annihilate them. And that's something we do not want to do, because there are many repercussions that would occur because of that. The stealth bombers that we flew over South Korea can carry up to 40,000 pounds of weapons, including conventional and nuclear weapons. Do I think we're being aggressive, too aggressive by doing so? Absolutely not. A leader of a country has threatened to use long-range ballistic missiles to strike us here in the United States. That is not something we take lightly. Nuclear fallout can kill many people and long-term devastating effects on our environment. One thing that we have to be very considerate and concerned about is if we are forced to striking North Korea because of their force against South Korea, the United States, or any of our allies, and we have to use what would be considered serious weapons, we have to be considerate of the fallout that could occur around the world, including the closest areas around North Korea, which would be Japan, China, Russia, Taiwan, South Korea. So this is something we have to be very concerned about, because certainly we don't want massive destruction of our environment and killing of many people. That's the last thing we want. What we want is peace, but peace is very difficult to come by with North Korea. I fully support the United States government doing what it must do to protect the United States of America. In God we trust that we have made the right decisions, and I'm going to show you this video here.
To see what appear to be long-range ballistic missiles that can be fired from mobile launchers with the capability of reaching the U.S. armed with a nuclear warhead.
Now, or why today, but late today at the Pentagon, the Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel made an announcement that sounded like something more from the height of the Cold War than mid-March of 2013. The U.S. is bolstering its nuclear missile defenses in Alaska and in Japan because of the threat mostly from North Korea, but also from Iran. And there are actually sources telling us tonight the U.S. is scrambling and going to this effort and expense, roughly $1 billion, because they believe the North Korean nuclear program is further along than they first thought. And their nuclear weapons, after all, are in the hands of an untested 28-year-old leader. It is where we begin tonight with our Pentagon correspondent, Jim McLeshevsky. He's on assignment tonight in St. Louis. Jim, good evening.
Good evening, Brian. With today's announcement about beefing up U.S. missile defenses, the Obama administration revealing that it now considers North Korea to be a serious threat against America's homeland. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un today reviewed his troops during military exercises. But at the Pentagon, Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel warned it's North Korea's long-range missiles that have sounded the alarm.
But North Korea in particular has recently made advances in its capabilities and is engaged in a series of irresponsible and reckless provocations.
To counter the growing threat from North Korea, the U.S. military will bolster the missile defense system in Alaska by 50%, adding 14 interceptor missiles at Fort Greely, designed to intercept and destroy ballistic missiles aimed at the continental U.S. The U.S. military will also install an additional high-powered radar in Japan to improve early warning capabilities. But why the deep concern now? Remarkably, it ramped up last April during this military parade through the streets of Pyongyang. U.S. intelligence was shocked to see what appeared to be long-range ballistic missiles that can be fired from mobile launchers with the capability of reaching the U.S. armed with a nuclear warhead.
Obviously, without getting into intelligence aspects, we watched this evolve into it very, very closely.
The latest threat emerged as North Korea launched a satellite into space orbit last December and conducted a successful underground nuclear test last month.
They still have a couple of technological hurdles, but this is not a long-term threat. This is a near-term threat.
And just recently, North Korea publicly threatened to launch a preemptive nuclear strike against the U.S. But as the U.S. military strengthens its missile defenses, Kim Jong-un was personally warned today, don't even think about it.
We believe that this young lad ought to be deterred by that, and if he's not, we'll be ready.
It'll be 2 to 3 years before that entire missile system in Alaska is up and running. And the $1 billion additional dollars it'll take to pay for it all won't show up in the shrinking Pentagon budget until sometime next year.
I wonder how the expression young lad will translate in North Korea. Jim McLeshevsky starting us off tonight on today's rare turn of events. Jim, thanks.